sun's going down here in Honolulu, and I am thinking about making a batch of lotion. So I'll show you how I do it. First, I fill up a pot of water and I want to bring that to boil. And I'm going to create a double boiler. So I have a glass bowl. So I'm just going to put the glass bowl right on top. I usually just always rinse out everything after it comes out of the dishwasher. So weird like that. And I just put it right over and it's gonna start boiling over there. And while that heats up, I'm gonna get all the ingredients. And so I'm gonna post all of the ingredients and like the link, I think, to like Amazon in case you guys want to get the same ones. So I've got a few different things here. And honestly, I only used 4 ingredients and it was really just awesome. I gave some to my mom and she said it was a little oily. So I think that this is really like a nighttime thing, and I do notice that as well, but it feels awesome. So yeah, I have here Nutiva coconut oil, bought it on Amazon. I literally bought all these things on Amazon. I have vitamin E oil, which is supposed to have like restorative properties for your skin. I have eczema and have had eczema like as a child, and it was like on my arm or like on my elbows and like on my knee. And you know, it really feels great to have something that will clear it up. My eczema will still flare up at times, like if I'm really stressed. So then I also have lavender essential oil. And then I have unrefined shea butter. So all of these things really, you know, are like 1 vegan, 2 they're just like natural ingredients that can heal your skin. So I'm gonna go ahead and put some of that into the glass bowl. And oh my gosh, this has a recipe for creamy lip gloss, which I do want to try, and I also am meaning to try beeswax in my products. And I really just eyeball it. What I love about making this is that it's like cooking, not baking, in the sense that it is just kind of, you know, there's no recipe. And I'm making just a really small batch. You know, online it says that these can sometimes last up to 6 months, but I rather just make really, really small batches and just keep it fresh. So I did about like half coconut butter, maybe a little more than half. I mean, sorry, coconut oil, and then shea butter for the rest of it. So I'm just gonna let that kind of, you know, melt down as it heats up here. And I'll show you a closer look. And since it is pretty much reaching sunset here, I am going to turn on the light. I'll be back. So here it is cooking down. Just gonna let it go a little bit longer. Now that it is pretty much clear and translucent, we're going to go ahead and remove it from the double boiler. And I just want to let it cool down at this point. I'm going to move it over to the freezer. So after about 25 minutes, I just took this out of the freezer, and as you can see, the consistency has changed. It looks kind of like cream, and so I'm getting the fork, and I am just kind of going at this like I would cream, as you can see. This is the consistency right now, and I'm gonna keep kind of going at this until it's smoother, but you can really make it whatever consistency you want, because at this point it really is ready. So it's really already, I think I like it more like this. And so you can kind of do it however you want. I'm still really experimenting. This is only my second time making it. Before I forget, you're going to want to put your other oils in there. So this lavender oil, and this is vitamin E oil. So I'm just going to do a few. Of each. I'm gonna go light on the lavender because last time it was a little heavy on the lavender. So yeah, I'm just experimenting with this myself and just thought it was something really cool that I wanted to share with everyone. So as you can see, I am just about finished here, and this is what it looks like. There's not a lot. I have a small little container to put it into, which I think is really cute. I just got this at Bed and Franklin. And so last time I piped it in, but this time, last time it was a lot more liquidy, so this time I'm gonna just kind of scoop it in there. Hope everyone enjoys their weekend. If you try my recipe for, I guess you can call this some body butter, then let me know. Subscribe. And I hope that you enjoyed spending some time learning how to make this tonight. This is really good, by the way, for eczemas or just like for any skin. It's just really, it's good. Ciao for now.